I was a lollipop, which is tits on a stick for a long time. And then suddenly I was, I don't know what I am, a column or something, who knows.
Pascale can make a joke of it now, but her family's medical history was no laughing matter.
My mother and my grandmother had had breast cancer, and also some aunts and cousins who had passed when they were very young.
After the birth of her second daughter, she became increasingly worried about the risk.
I just decided that for the sake of my children and my family, that I would have my breasts removed so that I was at peace with my risk and we could carry on living normally.
Like 60% of other women who have a mastectomy, Pascale had reconstructive surgery. But after a year of serious health complications caused by the implants, she decided to go flat.
It destroyed my life, choosing implants. I wish I had been told that flat closure would be the best choice for my health. I guess that women can be beautiful without breasts.
Breast surgeon Dr. Mary Ling says in days gone by, reconstructive surgery wasn't usually an option.
But these days, I guess women are pushed more towards reconstruction and having breasts because that's what we can do. But it might not necessarily be what a woman wants.
2 years ago, a survey found a third of women opted against reconstruction after a mastectomy.
It's a simpler operation, there's less risk of complications, it's a quicker recovery time, and some women place higher value in those things rather than having breasts.
Joanna Atsori had her right breast removed after a cancer diagnosis.
I spent 18 months as a uni-boober, which is where my remaining left breast was left intact and I was flat on my right side.
For the sake of symmetry, Joanna would purchase specially designed mastectomy bras. Eventually, she decided to go flat and hasn't looked back.
I love looking at myself in the mirror now. And the first time that I saw my flat chest after that surgery, I was over the moon.
Oh, I could have got a bigger one.
I love having the option of being breasted or unbreasted.
And at this lingerie shop, there's plenty of options.
Jo's had a couple of different sizes along the way.
Yep.
And that's been really good, that as she's changed, she's gone, oh, I want to be smaller, and like, we make her smaller, then she's back, I want to be bigger.
Yep.
And then we've made her bigger, so that's great.
Feels really nice. Yeah.
Looks lovely.
I love the fabric.
Yeah.
Back in Victoria, Pascale is hard at work painting a flat-chested mermaid.
Went through a period of painting a lot of mermaids. I definitely felt, when I had a lot of anxiety and depression, that I was drowning. I couldn't quite get out of the mess I was in, and I seemed to resonate with mermaids somehow.
And last weekend, on Great Keppel Island, she actually became one.
I love that. That looks gorgeous.
Pascale's friend, photographer Fifi Fogg, came up with the idea of featuring 12 flat women in a calendar shoot.
Women need to know that they have got that option to stay flat. They don't have to go through that whole process of getting implants done.
Beautiful. I think we're done.
Sweet.
She thought this would be the perfect opportunity to find 12 willing flat mermaids to dress up as mermaids and regain their flat bodies.
It's a really important message to tell, and it's a great time to be doing it.
They don't have to worry about where they're sitting.
Yeah.
No nipsies.
We've had a few women on the beach asking us what we're doing and why we're doing it, so it's pretty cool to tell them all about it and start getting that flat word out there.
I feel like I'm in my element. I love the feeling that I get from doing this, and I love the beach, I love the sea. It feels completely normal, you're feeling completely like yourself, and there's nothing to be fearful of. You can still be confident and happy as a flat woman.
What a beautiful message, because I think there's so much pressure as a woman if you are going to get your breasts removed to feel like, oh, am I a woman without them? Do I have to get... And to have all of those health complications that come along with that, the quality of life that you can have and feeling at peace with yourself and, like, you're still beautiful without, that is an amazing thing.
Mm. Yeah, I think some women as well think that their femininity is tied up with their breasts, but that's not true for everyone. And if it means getting back to your life quicker, great. I mean, my girlfriend survived breast cancer and she was happy to get a new pair of boobs, as she said, and she used to wear a T-shirt which said, these are fake because my real ones tried to kill me. So you do you,
that's
you do whatever works best for you.